Sarah asks, what tips is a great question. What tips for never running out of a car for use to do gig apps full time? That's a fantastic question. In your experience, did you just earn enough to save up for a new car? Have no desires to do a regular job again? If you're doing the gig economy full time or heavier part-time hours, number one, no, we're not saving up for a new car. All right, let's be, I'm gonna be frank with you as a team member. If you're not a team member, consider subscribing. Do not purchase a brand new car to do gig work. Even if you're doing it full time, doesn't matter. Now, number two, which car would you get if you're trying to maximize your income, but minimize your expenses and keep a vehicle? Because eventually that vehicle is gonna depreciate, it's gonna wear down and like break beyond the cost to repair it, etc. This is not financial advice, right? This is just my opinion. But then I would buy the most efficient, depreciated, cost-effective vehicle that I can. Again, a fuel-efficient vehicle that is depreciated, that's cost-effective. So really a compact or a subcompact car. Now keep in mind, you cannot do some apps with a compact car. So if your gig includes like Amazon Flex, you need at least a mid-sized car for Amazon Flex. So consider that as well. So let's keep it on mid-size. If I want a mid-size vehicle, I would look for a depreciated, I don't know, 3 years or whatever it is, whatever fits into your budget, that is great on gas mileage, ideally hybrid. I mean, as we move on years down the road, whatever, if you can go full electric, then go for it. And that is a vehicle I would get for solely gig work. I was getting that coffee this morning, and I looked over, and it appeared to be a food delivery driver that was driving an older whatever. I don't know if it wasn't a Prius, but it was an efficient vehicle. And I was thinking, that is a great vehicle to do gig work if it's a side hustle, you know, or a full time hustle. You don't want to buy a brand new vehicle. I understand, you know, if it's nice to have the new vehicle. I recently purchased a new vehicle. I'm not going to use that for gig work. Don't use a new vehicle unless you're driving like 5 hours a week and you feel okay using that brand new vehicle, especially because I know our roads and I know the busy areas. If I'm driving like Shadyside, Oakland, tight, narrow roads, especially in Oakland and different parts of Pittsburgh. Now, if I was in San Diego, then I might risk it a little bit more because it's newer infrastructure. It's much wider neighborhood roads, but it's not going to be my main vehicle. If it's your only vehicle, you know, if you have to buy a brand new vehicle, then I would look hybrid. If it's going to be a crossover vehicle for gig work as well. Those are a lot of things to consider. DoorDash Rick, does DoorDash have the right to pause dashers for not accepting orders, and is it writing in the terms of service? I'll tell you this, okay? Because this is gonna apply to any gig app. So listen to this. In the past, yes, some of these apps have timed you out for declining too many orders. But here's the thing. Now, at the time of filming this, no app, I don't think they had a hard lockout in the past. Correct me if I'm wrong. It booted you off and it said, due to inactivity, are you still accepting orders, blah, blah, blah. You can always go back online. To my knowledge, there's no hard lockout. And I don't believe they can do a hard lockout because you are an independent contractor and you are allowed to decline as many as you want. You can have a 1% acceptance rate. You can have a 0% acceptance rate. There should not be something in the terms of service. And frankly, in the terms of service, it says just that. You can decline as an independent contractor. Just don't accept and cancel. Obviously, that can get you deactivated. What am I saying? Yeah, don't cancel too much because that can and will get you deactivated.